how does Perfiti evaluate the plastic packaging market in context of single-use plastic ban? And what are the, you know, effort of Perfiti to counter the issue?
So, I think there are three levers that have to be used to manage on this problem and how to become sustainable. How do you have sustainable packaging? So one is that we remove completely something which is not sustainable. Second is to, if you can't remove, reduce the content. And the third option is to go for something which is recyclable. So as industry is working on all these three dimensions, three levers, so are we to see what can be done, what can be done to what extent in all these three dimensions.
If you take the total consumption of packaging, plastic packaging including all kind of packaging, what are the percentage of paper packaging, and in next 5 years, what are you expected to have the quantity of paper packaging?
So we have a significant proportion of packaging coming from paper-based materials. These include all our display boxes, these include cartons, these include various kind of labels, and the primary packaging is something which is still in the form of laminates or multi-layer materials. So this is where the attention is now, and the development work is taking place in a phased manner. Whenever possible, we will switch over to paper-based packaging materials. The shelf life has to be ensured so that the consumer, when he gets the product, he gets it as fresh as it is produced.
Are you planning to launch any product which has a 100% biodegradable packaging? Are you planning to launch? Have you launched any earlier?
No, we do not have, as of now, any material which has got primary packaging as completely paper. There is a paper layer in this, but not 100% paper, but it is on the drawing board, and the challenges are there, for which we are working with the industry, our own vendor partners, to see if we can switch over to completely paper-based biodegradable packaging.
What are the merits and demerits do you see when you see the paper packaging over the plastic packaging, and what properties should be enhanced to so that paper packaging can come close to the plastic packaging?
If we go back to old days, we only had paper packaging, and then we switched over to plastic based packaging because plastic was able to give you a higher shelf life for the product, ensuring the freshness stays longer. Now this was also then supported by the cost factor. Now that the sustainability part is becoming a challenge, we are forced to therefore look into paper again. And the technology is advancing, and I'm told in many places around the world, in UK, I'm told that there is a biodegradable paper which can also offer a similar shelf life as of laminates. And we have picked up some leads from there, and we are working on those dimensions.
What are the global trend do you see in biodegradable packaging which are yet to come to India?
So I am told that there is a material which is almost like a cellophane, which is based out of paper, which degrades very quickly. It comes with as strong barrier properties as the plastic laminates, which are metallized. This is yet to be commercialized, But the work is taking place on this at a very fast pace, and I'm sure this will soon become a reality for India as well.
What are the best way to dispose of the plastic, sir? Do you see? And since plastic has an adverse effect on the environment, how can we make it this adverse effect the positive effect?
How do we dispose of best? I will pick up an example. So we see the PET bottles which have got shrink film labels around them. Now, the disposal of these bottles with labels is a challenge. If you can have these bottles without labels, then it's possible to crush them, to use them again for recycling. So, small tips to consumers, sensitizing the consumers that when you dispose of a bottle, just remove the label out of it, makes a big help for the industry. So it is a matter of also educating the consumer, that is, it's in their own interest and for the interest of the environment that they be conscious of this. They dispose of these packagings by isolating them and not putting in the trash along with other kind of trash. So somebody who is now salvaging this, then it becomes easier for him to recover this at a lower cost. So the issue today is that picking up these kind of packaging materials from general trash results into a cost, and that is a big challenge.
In food applications, which the PET bottles we are using is a virgin grade bottles. Once we recycle it, can we use again in the food applications?
Yes. So the technology is now coming up in which the recycled PET bottles or the material of the used bottle gets crushed into smaller pieces, and a portion of this then gets used along with the virgin materials. And the technology is also coming up where you can blow a bottle with two layers. Okay, so the inner layer can be a virgin and the outer layer can be of mixed. Okay, so therefore the extent to which you use a virgin material reduces. So therefore you're reducing your consumption, and therefore you can then come up with something which is sustainable from a long term.
What are your grievances? What do you want to say to the paper manufacturers?
To the paper manufacturers, based on whatever I have experience in buying the paper from the industry, there is lack of transparency in terms of the specifications and the cost equation. Okay, so which means that you will offer a price for a particular set of specifications. However, those specifications are not generally complied with. Okay, and there are reasons given which are not actually the real reasons or real facts. Those are, I think, more or less to cover up. To cover up on the cost side and make an equation which is unfair as far as a buyer is concerned, equation of unfair price versus specifications.